evening, everybody. My name is Liam.
I'm Molly.
And this year we were the directors for Frontier Regional's FRED, which stands for Real Entertainment, Duh. So this year we have really tried our best to put together something really fantastic for all of you to watch. We hope that all of you enjoy it. It's been about 5 months in the making, and everybody in the cast really has had some choice or another in directorial decisions, so we really hope that you just enjoy the hard work that we put into this for 5 months. Enjoy the show.
Enjoy.
It's based off our names. So this morning, Liz and I have a meeting with a very demanding new client, the CEO of Cultured Yogurt Water. And Liz, better wake up. So what do you have for us this morning?
Cultured Yogurt Water.
Oh.
I think a lot of women like the idea of something being, you know, medium thick.
You know, they like that chunky consistency with the water at the top.
Yeah, try it.
Thank you. I will try it.
You know, I think that on top of the consistency, something that a lot of women these days are looking for is something with that sour taste that only yogurt can bring. So, what can we do to help promote your product? I just had an amazing idea.
What?
An event.
Oh my God, Liz, you're a genius.
I know, I love you. You're my best friend.
You're my best friend.
Best friend. Okay, so we've decided we're going to do an event. Cultured yogurt water is very...
cultured.
And what's more cultured than London, England?
So smart. You're so smart.
So, we're going to do an event featuring cultured yogurt waters around cultured London, England, and we can have Adele perform!
Oh my God, I love Adele!
I think Adele might be a bit expensive.
I mean, I could perform if you wanted to. It's, you know, free, so I could perform.
Liz is crazy untalented, and I don't think she can deliver. So, you know, I was also thinking that perhaps we could just have this tiny little monkey with anger issues smashing on cymbals. I thought that was a great idea, too.
You know what, Liz? I'm gonna stop you right there, because I would be super duper concerned that the cute little monkey would just be singing and jump out and scratch someone right in the face, and then, you know, we might be sued. So I could perform.
Yeah, let's try it.
Liz can perform, or that monkey, or literally anybody else. It's completely your decision.
Yeah, I think Liz should have a song.
Yeah, sure, amazing, try it.
Do you want me to sing to you? Okay, 1 second, let me warm up. Okay, ooh, voice crack, okay. I would love to sing at the event.
Well.
I'm really good.
I think that right there is proof positive that we should consider a bunch of options.
Me.
Here's your change, and thank you for shopping at Target.
No, thank you. You've been a wonderful cashier.
All right, take it. Come on, get out of here.
Are you okay?
Yeah, take a drawer and get the F out of here. I'm on the clock and ready to rock.
But that was a customer.
You're a fool and you know it. Get out of here.
It's just a job lead.
Oh God, I'm so excited for someone to come in. I just want to look him in the face. Welcome to Target. Welcome to Target.
Thanks, just the stuff.
Oh, fantastic. What do we have here? Madagascar, baby! Oh, I love DreamWorks. And what are these? Paper plates? Do you think you can take two of these, stick them down your pants, and they'll make your bum look flat? Flat is where it's at.
I don't think that's true.
And this? Degree deodorant? And the scent is Cool Rush? Where did you find this?
The toiletry section. Hey, where are you going? The cashier just left.
Wait a second. Does she look like a middle-aged turtle with brown lips and a hair helmet?
Yeah.
Oh, hell no. I cannot deal with her today.
next to her Acura.
Okay, I'm sorry, but my girlfriend's waiting for me in the car, so...
Your... what?
My girlfriend.
Are you a lesbian? I've never met one of you before. Do you all wear vests?
Well, I'm not wearing one now, so...
Stereotype busted! Oh god, I learn something new every day here at Target. Did you know Coca-Cola is dark brown? Oh god. Okay, your total is gonna be $448.
That's not right.
Oh god, you're right. Do you know what this means? I get to do something very special. A void! But first, I think I need a little bit of energy. How about half an almond? Better. Your new total's gonna be $38.49, and here's a wink for free.
Thanks, I'll just pay cash.
Are you sure? You can pay with your card. I'll cross my eyes so I don't even see your secret code. You still there? Well, thanks for coming to Target. Oh God, my eyes. Feels like I've been staring at that sun again. My blood sugar's getting low, low, low. Better eat the other half of that almond. Oh, delicious. Who's ready for customer service to die for?
Hi, I'd just like to buy these.
Oh, fantastic. What do we have here? Birthday? Graduate? Oh. Oh, God. Says here someone died. And I just said customer service to die for. Open mouth insert, Target sock covered foot.
No, I just wanted to buy them so I'd have them on hand, in case I need them.
Are you a hoarder? Sometimes I think I am.
I mean, I don't know you, but I think you probably are.
I have every issue of Sassy Magazine.
Why?
I like to cut the model's eyes out and put them over my own while I sleep. That way, my birds think I'm awake and the ghosts know I'm there.
There's no such thing as ghosts.
I have a ghost. And her name is Dr. Gail Perkins. I think she's stuck between realms. What do I do?
Move?
Oh, honey, there you are. We need these two.
What are these?
Feminine protection for...
Feminine protection for what?
Well, you know, every month a woman...
goes to Florida just to get a quick look at Florida?
What are you talking about?
Where'd you find these?
Wait, aisle 7? Wait, where are you going?
I don't know. Hey, let's just go to the bicycle shop.
The bicycle shop? Who are you, Charlie Tebbets?
Sweet Mary, I found him! I'm gonna get these nice and wet and put them around the side of my toilet so my grannies can sit there. While I'm at it, I should probably buy them some jackets, maybe a strawberry candle, some charcoal, some trugula, some Pabst indoor-outdoor birdseed.
I can't believe you dragged me.
Oh, come on, Jason. It'll be fun.
Fun? This whole thing is just a big ripoff. I don't even believe in...
fortune tellers!
Ha ha. Very clever.
Whoa.
Take a seat.
Thank you.
Madame Zeroni is my name. Fortune telling is my game. Do not show fear. Please make your way. For channels of truth are told to those who pay. Tales of mystery told of all. Just look inside my crystal ball.
Jesus Christ.
So, what is it you seek?
I want to know my...
future? The universe is full of spirits who nestle. I am merely one of their spiritual vessels. using their knowledge and not what they hold. What in particular do you wish to know?
Okay, could you just quit talking in those rhyme schemes? This isn't Dr. Seuss hour. Come on, Troy, can we just get this crap over with so I can go home?
I can tell you are distressed. Everything in your life is a mess. A dark path in life will follow thee. If not, seek the help of Madame Stramboni!
What?
What is it you wish to know about your future?
I want to know if I will be
famous?
Holy shit.
How are you doing that? It's like you're finishing all my
sentences!
Oh, I know what you are! You're a
pilot! Oh, come on, don't tell me you're gonna fall for this garbage.
Do not deny the unforeseen, for future's cold will wipe you clean.
That doesn't even make any sense.
Madame Stramboni has spoken!
What, are you Italian?
Madame Rigatoni has spoken!
Please, please, tell us more.
Okay, this is getting stupid. I want to leave right now.
What? Come on, Jason, you can't leave. It's just getting good. And besides, don't judge a book
by its cover!
What? You literally set her up for that one. You know what? That's it. I'm out of here.
Leave now, for you seem not to care. You will meet your fate by the dangerous stairs.
Oh my god, shut up!
No, actually those stairs are like really messed up and rotted, so just like, be careful, you might fall. What? Come on, JC, you can't leave. Besides, I don't have any money, and this kind woman is sacrificing her time and energy to give us reliable information about our future. Can't just walk out.
Let's just get this over with.
Good, good, now listen well, for futures are shown to those who dwell. It is just a simple task. Look into my crystal ball and ask.
Ooh, pick me,
wait,
pick
I got
me,
a question.
Pick.
I got one. When will I die?
Well.
What's the matter? Look into your magic ball and tell me when I'm going to die.
Some knowledge of the future is best left unknown.
Ugh, look, you're not getting paid until you tell me my future. Unless you're a fake.
Fine, fine. If it is your death you seek, hopefully your future won't be so bleak. Says you will die when you are old and happy.
Ooh, how supernatural of a prediction.
Wait, there's something else.
What? What is it?
It says you'll be very badly injured and very, very soon.
Okay, this is just ridiculous. I'm out of here.
No, wait. You need to be careful.
No, you know what? This whole thing has just been a big waste of my time, all right? You're not getting a cent out of me. Come on, Troy. Let's get out of here.
Oh, okay.
No,
oh,
wait.
Dragging these places.
The stairs! Watch out for the stairs!
Well, that's all the time I have for today.
But, I'm sure he's fine. Now on your way! Madame Ravioli has spoken!
No, no tuna.
You're out
of tuna? No tuna. Cheeseburger? No. Come on, we haven't got all day. We got a tuna, but come on, what do you gonna want? What do you gonna want? What do you have?
I'll have a grilled cheese and a Coke.
Grilled cheese?
No grilled cheese.
No grilled cheese.
Okay, cheeseburger and a Coke.
No Coke, Pepsi.
Okay, Pepsi and fries.
No fries, chip.
Okay, chips.
One cheeseburger, one Pepsi, one chip.
Cheeseburger.
Pepsi?
I'll have a cheeseburger and a Coke.
No Coke, Pepsi.
Pepsi.
One cheeseburger, one Pepsi!
Cheeseburger.
Pepsi?
Cheeseburger, 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 four Pepsi, chip.
Oh, how you doing, Pete? I'll have usual.
Cheeseburger!
Cheeseburger.
Now say, is that your brother over there?
Him? No, my brother Mike is in the back. That's my first cousin George, but I treat him like a brother. Sandy, she's over there. She's my second cousin, but I treat her like a first cousin. Nico, he's my third cousin, but I treat him like a fourth cousin. He's Vlahos. You know what that means? Stupid. Hello, I'll be at the restaurant. Cheeseburger, 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 cheeseburger!
Cheeseburger, 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 cheeseburger.
No fried chip. Pork chip! Okay, anything you drink? No Coke, Pepsi. No orange, no grape, no Coke, Pepsi. Pork Pepsi! Got to go? Okay, 10 minutes.
All right, a couple of beds and sausage. Is that link sausage or patty? Link? Link? Link sausage, large orange juice, and some coffee.
Cheeseburger.
No, I don't want a cheeseburger. Eggs, couple of eggs. Do you speak English? Yeah? Yeah? Eggs, over lightly, with sausage. Cafe. Cafe.
And no eggs. Cheeseburger.
When do you stop serving breakfast?
Now, no breakfast.
No breakfast?
Nope.
I just want a couple of eggs.
No eggs. Cheeseburger?
Shut up! I don't want a cheeseburger.
Come on, don't give me that. You want a cheeseburger? Everybody got a cheeseburger. Everybody got a cheeseburger. You want a cheeseburger? What do you want?
No, I don't want a cheeseburger. I just got up. It's too early for a cheeseburger.
Too early for a cheeseburger? Look. Cheeseburger.
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 What do you want? What are you gonna have?
I'll have a cheeseburger.
Cheeseburger! No more cheeseburger.
All
right, how about a hamburger then?
Hamburger!
No more hamburger.
No cheeseburger, no hamburger, no burger.
All right, how about a couple of eggs?
Eggs?
Over lightly?
Scrambled.
All right, scrambled.
Anything to drink?
Yeah, Coke.
No Coke, Pepsi.
All right, Pepsi.
Pepsi!
Hey, Pepsi, 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 Pepsi!
Sending out an SOS, sending out an SOS, sending out an SOS.
Okay, all right. Thank you very much, Sean. That was wonderful. Yeah.
Yes. Okay. Yes. Thank you.
All right. That's. I'm afraid
the police rule.
Yes. The policemen are indeed a very good man. Okay. Next at St. Monica's High School.
Message in a bottle.
Yes. All right. Yes. Yes. They do send
those.
Okay. Thank you. Next at St. Monica's High School talent show is a Miss Mary Catherine Gallagher.
Mary Catherine Gallagher.
Hello.
Catherine Gallagher.
Now, Miss Gallagher, it says here that you're I'm sorry, but what are you doing with your hands?
It's just sometimes when I get nervous, I stick my hands in my armpits and I smell like this. That's gross.
That's really gross. Yeah, that's really gross. That's interesting, man. Now, it says something about your grandmother here.
Yes, my grandmother. My grandmother. I'm going to tell you about my grandmother. She is my legal guardian, and she lives in a motorized wheelchair. Oh. And she says, I bear a very striking resemblance to young Elizabeth Dale.
I can see that, yes. So next on the list, it says you have a monologue.
A monologue, yes. Monologue. Oh, I have a monologue today. I have a monologue from my favorite made-for-TV movie, The Betty Broderick Story, starring Meredith Baxter Burney.
Take it away.
It was dawn, and the sun was just barely rising. And I got out of bed, and I went into the wooden box in my room, and I got out the gun. I went downstairs, I went outside, and I got in my car. And I drove vroom, vroom. I drove over to Dan Broderick and Linda's house. And then I got out. And I snuck in their front door. And I climbed up their stairs. And I got into their bedroom and I saw them sleeping there, Dan and Linda. And I just shot them both. I hate you, Dan! I hate you! I hate you! I hate you!
Hey, thank you.
Monologue!
Thank you, Mary. Very good. Very good. Okay. Next on the agenda here, it says you have a song.
I have a song, yes. I also have a song today. I have one of my favorite songs, yes. Yes.
Okay, yes. Take it away.
Do you know I'm asking if I love you? Yes. Okay. Yes. I'm sorry. You ask me if I love you.
and I choke on my reply. I'd rather tell you honestly than mislead you with a lie. 'Cause sometimes when we touch,
gymnastics. Backflip! Backflip! Backflip!
Stop! Stop it! Control yourself, woman!
I'm sorry, Father.
It's okay. You got a bit carried away there. That's all.
Just right? A little bit. Just
yeah,
a little bit.
Are we under control now?
Yes, Father. Okay, I'm under control.
We're under control now. That's good. Okay. You see, I'm writing your name down here.
Mary Catherine Gallagher. Mary Catherine.
Mary Catherine Gallagher.
Catherine.
And we're going to send you back to class now, and we'll call you back later. Is that okay?
Yes, thank you.
All right, thank you.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you very much. A big hand for Mary Catherine Gallagher. St. Monica's High School talent show is Peter O'Connelly and his step dancing monkey.
How many times has this happened to you? You have a bass and you're trying to find an exciting new way to prepare it for the dinner table. You could try scaling the bass, cutting out the fish's head, tail, and bones, but why bother with Ravco's amazing new kitchen tool, the Super Bass-O-Matic 76? Yes, fish eaters, the day of troublesome scaling, cutting, and gutting are over because the Super Bass-O-Matic 76 is the tool that allows you to use the entire fish with absolutely no fish waste. Here's how it works. First, catch a bass. Then, remove the hook. Then, drop the bass. Yes, that's the whole bass into the Super Bass-O-Matic 76. Now, adjust the control dial so it's blended just the way you like it. Yes, it's that simple. Would anyone like to try it?
Yeah.
You, come on up here. Here, fast, easy, and ready to pour. Super Bass-O-Matic 76 comes with 9 interchangeable rotors, a 10-month guarantee, and a booklet. 1,001 ways to harness bass. Super Bass-O-Matic 76 also works great on sunfish, sole, perch, and other small aquatic creatures. Super Bass-O-Matic 76. It's fun, clean, and simple. And after 5 or 10 fish, it gets to be quite a rush. Super Bass-O-Matic 76. You'll never have to scale, cut, or gut again.
St. Angel's Soup Kitchen. These dinners, they're just so much fun. Last year, we ate and talked and laughed and had such a fun time that we didn't leave until 8 o'clock. I'm talking p.m.
Well, my name's Lisa, and this is my first time doing this, so I'm really excited.
And I am Lou, and seeing all these wonderful faces here today really warms my heart.
It warms my heart, too. Mine's burning a lot, though. It's like a little ball of fire underneath my bra. Can't say the Pledge of Allegiance or I'll burn my hand. So guess my heart's a little warmer than yours is.
Thank you, Penelope, was it? Anyways, as I was saying, this is a very special time of year for me because, interesting factoid, according to Ancestry.com, I actually had relatives come over on the Mayflower.
Well, I had relatives come over on the April flower, so they came 1 month before yours did. Just 1 month before yours did, so.
Good to know. Oh, I can see that people are starting to arrive, so everybody get your aprons on.
Happy Thanksgiving!
Oh, happy Thanksgiving! Happy Turkey Day! Happy Valentine's Day! Happy 4th of July! Probably get to see a lot of fireworks, because you live outside, so.
Penelope!
I think I have the door. Why don't you help serve the corn?
Mashed potatoes?
Yes, please. They're my favorite.
Well then, maybe I could sneak you a little extra.
I'll sneak you a little too. Just gonna sneak you a little bit more than she did. Wow. Just a little bit more than she would have, so. Yep, there you go.
Penelope! You can't serve that much mashed potatoes to one person!
Oh, don't be so hard on her. She means well.
All right, just no more big silverware, okay? Pastor Mike, it's so good to see you.
Happy Thanksgiving. Look at all these turkeys. And there's food here, too.
Oh, Pastor Mike, you tell such great jokes.
I took a joke to you. Did you hear about the peanut in Central Park? It was assault. So. But a great crowd. Thanks for that.
Pastor Mike, I saved you a drumstick.
Well, don't mind if I do. Come by my table and say hi. My whole family's here. All three of them.
My parents are too. But there's six of us, so they're double bigger than yours. So, here they come.
So, Mary, some of the folks were wondering if we could turn up the volume on the football game.
Of course I can!
Why are you doing it? So, I'm just gonna turn it up a little bit louder than you would have. Just a little louder than you would have, so.
Pastor Mike wasn't here, I kicked that girl in the giblets!
Oh, that's the longest pass I've ever seen! But wait! No one is even in the end zone. What are they doing?
Who is that in the end zone?
It's me. I got it, so, touchdown.
What is even happening?
Does anybody want this football? I can't play anymore. I just got tested positive for steroids.
I can't believe her. She's acting like she's the queen of Thanksgiving or something.
I am the queen of Thanksgiving. I now dub thee Sir Gobble the Waddle-up. So, congratulations.
Really, Penelope, really? You're the queen of Thanksgiving? Well, I'm the president of Wednesdays. And I drive a tanning bed to work. And if I clap three times, a wiener dog appears. And my dad's a chocolate chip. And when I get stressed, I drink two pot of soup. So, what do you think about that?
Well, I guess all I can say is that my tanning bed drives me to work in the morning so I can read the newspaper and have my coffee. And if I clap twice, all the dogs in the world get an extra wiener. And my dad's a chocolate chip cookie, so your dad's baked inside him. And if I want to relax, I shrink a pot of soup and use celery stick as a raft, so.
I cannot believe her. This is a day of thanks and she's made it all about herself.
Mary, calm down. Just try to have some food and relax.
You're right. I'm sorry, I've overreacted.
Mary, I think we have a situation over here.
Happy Thanksgiving. I'm not thankful for anything. I'm thankful for five, which is a little bit more than you, so I'm a little bit more thankful than everybody else, so happy Thanksgiving. Happy Thanksgiving.
Be asking you a few questions.
Is this really necessary?
Unfortunately for you, we have to follow every lead that comes through our system. Sure it's nothing big, you'll be out of here in a jiffy.
Okay. I just told my family ring about me if I'm not home for dinner.
Oh, you don't have to worry about that. We'll get these for you. Ridiculous. All right.
So, can you tell me where you were on the night of October 31st at around 8 p.m.?
I was handing out candy to the local children with my wife.
Are you sure you weren't selling crack?
Sir, I can assure you, I was not selling crack.
Because a man matching your description was seen on your block selling crack.
Sir, I was only handing out candy to the local trick-or-treaters.
Ha, 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 ha,
handing out candy to trick-or-treaters? That's a load of crap, and you know it! You were busy selling crack to your dopehead buddies, weren't you, big-time drug slanger?
Sir, I can't...
Shut up!
Hey, what's the big idea here?
I was just trying to scare this kid's pants off.
Hey, sorry about that. What's your name?
Jeff Baker.
Oh, really? I know Robert Baker down on River Road.
Oh, yeah, that's my uncle.
Well, I'll be. It's nice to meet you, Mr. Baker.
Nice to meet you, Officer...
Beck, but you can call me George.
Nice to meet you, Officer George.
Now, Jeff, could I just ask you one question?
Of course.
Where were you on the night of October 31st at around 8 p.m.?
I was handing out candy to the local
trick-or-treaters. Oh, come on! That is a load of crap, and you know it! Trick-or-treaters, more like trick-or-tweakers! Listen up here, you dirty crackhead. If you don't tell me where you really were, you'll be sipping your crack out of a straw by the time I'm done with you!
Commissioner!
We were just giving this scumbag here a run for his money.
Gentlemen! This is far from professional. We here at the South Deerfield Police Department do not act like animals when interrogating such a fine man as this'n. I mean, my God, we're the greatest city in the world. Now, champ, Jeff is it, right? You can understand why we are a little on edge about this whole crack dealer situation, can't you?
Yes, it's very scary, especially as a father.
I see. So, you really wouldn't mind answering me just this one question?
Of course.
Where were you on the night of October 31st at 8 p.m.?
I was handing out candy to look. Oh, no!
Why the long face?
Our next prisoner is a Mr. Wallace Redding. Mr. Redding, we've heard that you've served 40 years of a life sentence.
That's right, sir.
Now, would you say that you feel rehabilitated?
Rehabilitated? It's a funny question. I don't believe I know the meaning of the word. Is the man that entered this prison the same man you see before you? Absolutely not. Am I a saint? No, just a man. A man who has paid his debt to society. But whatever your answer is today, I'll respect it. For I know that in the eyes of the Lord, I am a free man, free from sin. I humbly await your answer.
No, hell no. You ate a guy.
You're the Texas... You're the Texas man gobbler. We'd be insane if we let you out.
You are never getting out of here.
There are no cameras in here. I'd kill you myself, you sick son of a bitch.
The answer is no.
An emphatic no.
I know you have a lot to discuss. The truth get... Listen, for those of you who are still on the fence, I have taken a hard look at my life. Things I've done. Things I shouldn't have done.
No one is on the fence here. You ate a guy in prison last week. A new guy.
You ate a whole guy, man. All that was left was just clothes and hair. That's like a magic trick.
Listen, this is a decision on whether or not you get the chair. And you do. You absolutely do.
I know you have a lot to discuss. The truth gets hazy in the pit. Did I eat those people? Yes. Did I enjoy it? Immensely. Would I do it again? Point me towards a homeless shelter. So whether I stay in here or whether you set me free, either way, I am going to eat another man. Now, I can't make this decision for you, but...
You don't have to. It's been made. You're never getting out of here.
The only thing you should be thinking about is what you want for your last meal.
A man.
I'm sorry?
For my last meal. One man, please.
No!
Two boys.
No!
Fine. One boy.
No!
Fine. Shake Shack. Now is the day I escaped from prison and met up with my good friend Andy in Zihuatanejo. We watched the sunset, had a couple of beers, and when he was good and drunk, I ate him. This is my exercise stick.
Huh. What's your routine?
Well, I do 3 sets of 15 with this arm and then half that with this arm.
Why is that?
Hi, everyone, and welcome to Ew. My name is Sarah, and if you're wondering, that is S-A-R-A with no H's, because H's are ew. So my mom's best friend from college is here this week, and she was wondering if her daughter could come on the show. So please, everyone, welcome Natalie Benson! Ew!
Ew!
Thank you for coming on the show today, Natalie.
Well, thanks for having me, because I really like to chill out. I just really like to hang out all the time.
Tell us a little bit more about yourself, you know?
Well, my name's Natalie, and I'm 13, and I like to eat apricots, and I have a Band-Aid collection.
Ew. What do you like to do for fun?
Sometimes I like to build popsicle stick castles by myself sometimes.
I can so relate to that. TV! Do you watch TV? My favorite show is Pretty Little Liars.
No, my mom hasn't let me watch TV since Miley Cyrus twerked.
Oh, that is too bad! Because you would love TV. You would really like TV. You would love Pretty Little Liars. Time for show and tell! What did you bring us this week?
This is a drawing of an invention that I did. It's a unicorn and a pegasus combined. That's an invention that I did.
I guess it's pretty.
Oh, Jesus! It's all over the pie bar! I'm not gonna touch that now!
My turn. For my show and tell, I have a wet sponge, and I will also be dancing to my favorite song, Come and Get It, by Selena Gomez.
Shake and bake chicken. First you shake it, and then you bake it. You put the chicken in the bag, and you put the chicken in the oven, and you give it a bake.
Oh my God, Gary, can you just get lost?
All right, I will catch you girls on the flippity flop.
Time for the ew speed round. Rice pudding.
Ew.
Yield signs.
Ew.
Airplane mode.
Ew.
Breaking up.
Ew.
Getting back together.
Never. Ever. Ever. Ever!
Okay. Sean Connery.
Cute.
Really?
Yeah, he's like an amazing actor. Haven't you ever seen League of Extraordinary Gentlemen?
Leg of Extraordinary Gentlemen? Never seen it before in my life. Never seen it. And finally, Shake and Bake Chicken.
Ew!
Danger, ew! Well, thank you for coming to the show this week, guys. Thank you so much, and ta-ta.
Germaphobes of America, unite! Germaphobes on three. One, two, three.
Welcome back. I'm here with Deborah, freelance cartoonist.
Deborah, are you excited?
I am, Carl. I can't believe I made it to the Super Showcase.
Well, we're excited, and our showcase models are excited, too.
Congratulations, Deborah. You're on your way.
You two look beautiful tonight.
Thanks, Carl. Sean is wearing Christopher Kane.
And Bond is wearing a Christopher Kane knockoff.
Well, you both look lovely. Now, Deborah, before the break, we asked you a question, and your answer was beef.
That's right, beef.
All right, let's find out what our showcase models think. Shonda, what do you think?
I think it could be beef.
Okay, Vonda, what do you think?
I'm not sure that it's beef, Carl, but beef sounds right.
Definitely beef.
Okay, the Super Showcase. Let's find out what the answer is. Is it beef? Nine. Nine. The answer is nine, not beef.
I almost said nine.
But you said beef, which is wrong. Now, why don't you show Deborah what she could have won?
Bad news, Deborah. You didn't win his and her luggage by Luggage Guy.
If it's not luggage, it's just a bunch of luggage from some place.
You win the talk of baggage claim with luggage for baggage.
I'm sorry you didn't win that, Deborah.
I am too. I would have loved that.
Well, that's not all you didn't win.
If you love golf, you'll be bummed about the next prize you didn't win.
It's a real hole-in-one.
It's a glamorous one-day, no-night stay at Pebble Beach Golf Resort.
You'll be golfing all day and leaving before dinner, courtesy of Pebble Beach.
And that's not all. You'll be a real swinger with these.
It's a matching golf club from Golfing Gee.
You sad you didn't win that, Deborah?
Sad is putting it mildly.
Well, you're gonna kick yourself when you find out what Shonda and Vonda have in their cart.
Bad news, Deborah. You didn't win a lifetime supply of chicken from Chicken Man.
Imagine years after years after years of chicken right at your fingertips.
Each chicken looks as good as this one. That's the Chicken Man guarantee.
If your man likes chicken, he might like Chicken Man.
Well, do you like chicken, Deborah?
I do, Carl. I can't believe I didn't win the showcase.
Bye, Deborah.
Better luck next time,
wait,
Deborah.
Wait, wait, that's not all. There's more.
Oh, wait. Vonda, come back. There's another showcase left in your car.
Oh, goodness. I'm coming back. I'm coming back. I can't stop it.
Just cut it.
I'm not here. Take this.
It's a clock for your mantle from Klockenfrau. It's made of wood, and I think it works.
That wasn't supposed to happen. Now, Deborah, I hope you had a nice time tonight.
It was okay.
Well, I'm afraid that's all the time we have left.
So, oh my God! Bonda got decapitated, but she's still running around showing things off. Come on,
let's go check this out.
Let's go. We have a very special treat for you. Goth and Cat.
Hey.
Are you guys okay?
We just forgot we were coming here.
Well, I mean, we knew. We just thought it was next week.
I mean, I could have you back another time if you
want. No.
We're all ready.
Okay, good. I'm really excited to see what you put together for me. I hear you've been working really hard.
Oh yeah, practicing, rehearsing, you name it.
The whole deal.
Okay, well, let's get to it.
All right.
Okay.
Go ahead.
One, two, three, four. There were
47. Presents.
Presents.
Under my...
tree.
Couch. Tree.
And
Santa was
on the roof.
I'm sorry. Roof? Is that even a song?
We're kidding!
Well, it's a comedy show, isn't it, Seth?
Oh yeah. I mean, I just feel like I can have you back another time. You know, when you're
more
prepared.
No, we got this.
We got this one.
This one's for real. All right.
Okay. We're doing it.
Okay.
One, two, three, four! Christmas comes right after Thanksgiving.
It's in December. Kids get presents. I mean, they do.
Cole, too. And when
I'm sorry to interrupt.
Oh, no, you did it.
Sorry?
Yeah.
That was the end of the song.
In the middle of the sentence. That was the end of the song?
Yes.
Perfect timing.
I just feel like you guys aren't really very prepared for this.
Oh, come on. Come on, Seth. We took a very long time writing and arranging these songs.
Have I ever asked you for anything, sir?
This is the first time I've met you.
Oh, come on, Seth. We came all the way from the center of town.
There are producers waiting to hear our sound.
Well, I guess in the spirit of Christmas, we can hear one more.
All right. This one's for real.
It had better be.
Okay.
One, two, three, four!
Santa's coming tonight, tonight! Santa's coming tonight!
That's my favorite song.
Santa's coming tonight, tonight! Santa's coming tonight!
Good night, Deerfield. Thank you very much.
Santa's coming tonight, tonight! Santa's coming tonight!
WNBA, I know our love is one for the ages.
And now for the bride.
My dearest little Anne, before I met you, the only time I felt truly alive was when I was out on the court, throwing elbows, pushing bitches, wearing my plastic face mask, fouling out in the first quarter, and laying sisters out.
Yeah.
Now that I have you, my life's complete.
Beautiful, absolutely beautiful. And at this time, if there are any objections as to why these two should not be joined in holy matrimony, speak now or forever hold your peace. I see most of the audience is raising their hands. Why don't we start with you?
Hi, I'm Marnie. I'm the bride's roommate. Alberta, you barely know this man. You met him 5 days ago at a combination Taco Bell Pizza Hut. And in the limited time you've had together, you have had sex 50 times in our shared living space. And in the rare moments when you're not going at it, you're having full-on screen fights on the front lawn. Please, don't do this.
Marnie, I love you, but you're a hater and you're jealous. Marnie, think of it like this. You're not losing a roommate, you're gaining one.
Yes, the lady in the second row.
Hi, Ian. Remember me? I'm your wife, Patricia. A quick question. Why are you throwing away our marriage like this?
And to that I reply, I'm not throwing anything away. I'm hitting a clutch three-pointer right at the buzzer, and that's happiness.
I see we've got a line of objections forming in the aisle. Why don't you step right up, sir?
Thank you. Yes, I'm the father of the bride. Alberta, you gotta be straight with this man. Just how many kids do you think she has?
I'll say three.
Three. Three? Well, double it and add four.
Daddy, do not ruin this for me.
Ten. 10 kids. You just adopted the goddamn Wu-Tang Clan.
Although she has actively deceived me in this manner, I have deceived her as well. I am not the King of England, and the only castle I own is a white castle.
We good. Who's the next dummy?
Hi, yes, I'm an ER doctor at a local hospital, and late last night this man was admitted with what I can only describe as a shattered groin.
Yeah, that's my bad, sorry.
Well, after about 10 hours of surgery, I was just barely able to reconstruct.
Barely.
It is still very, very touch and go, and would best be described as a late stage Jenga tower. Listen, I am so scared for what could happen to this man, because if one wrong move is made, Jenga.
Thanks. Bye.
Yeah, bye.
The young lady in the basketball shoes.
Yo, I'm Alberta's teammate, Cassidy. Go Lady Bears!
Anyways, Alberta, I know you love this guy, but you gotta keep your head in the game. Coach says we have a real shot this year. I mean, a WNBA championship. We'd be set for life. $5,000 split among us.
Maybe she has a point.
Baby, listen to me. I can do both. By day, I'll pull down those rebounds, and by night, I'll pull down my drawers.
Well, we have time for one more objection.
Thank you.
people. I happened to catch a quick glimpse of them as I walked by. Now, I'm a mild-mannered person. I don't get involved and I don't speak in groups. But when I saw these two, every hair on my body stood up and they said, Evelyn, you get in there and you shut this down. Also, I'm a psychic, and I can tell you with complete confidence, this all ends with a gruesome murder and a big and tall shot. The murder weapon? An extra large plastic hanger.
Ladies and gentlemen, we hear your concerns.
We have.
We understand your trepidation.
We do.
We understand that we are two very different people.
And you know what? Salt. You are all salt.
Salt indeed. And no amount of salt can keep this man from his essential nutrients.
Well, if that's all, I'd like to add my objection to the mix and pronounce you man and wife. You may kiss the bride.
Track down. By the way, for those of you who don't know, my name is Bruce Dickinson. Yes, the Bruce Dickinson. And although Blue Oyster Cult, the worst name I've ever heard, you guys seem to have a pretty dynamite sound.
Come for you, Bruce. That means a lot.
Yeah, I mean, you're Bruce Dickinson.
This is incredible.
I can't believe Bruce Dickinson digs our sound.
Oh, listen, guys. I put my pants on just like the rest of you, one leg at a time. But once I do, I make gold records. All right.
Classic.
Fear, don't fear the Reaper. Take one. Roll it.
1, 2, 3, 4!
Are you sure I'm sounding good?
To be honest, sounded fantastic, but could have used a little more cowbell. So, let's take it again. And, Gene?
Yeah?
Really explore the studio space this time.
You got it, Bruce.
I mean, really explore it. Roll it again.
1, 2, 3, 4!
But you know, I find Gene's cowbell playing to be a little distracting. I don't know about anybody else, I'll shut up, but...
Nah, man, it's pretty rough.
I mean, I could pull it back a little, if you'd like.
Not too much, though. I'm telling you guys, you're gonna want that cowbell on that track. So, let's roll it again.
1, 2, 3, 4! Come on, Gene!
Come on! No, it doesn't work. I gotta have more cowbell.
Don't blow this for us, Gene.
Quit being so goddamn selfish, Gene.
Can I just say one thing?
Say it, baby.
I'm standing here, staring at rock legend Bruce Dickinson.
Cock of the walk, baby.
And if Bruce Dickinson says that we need more cowbell, well, we should probably give him more cowbell.
Goddamn right, baby.
And you know what, Bobby? I am being selfish. But the last time I checked, we don't have a whole lot of songs that feature the cowbell! You know, maybe I could just, you know, leave for a second, come back a little later, and we could lay this cowbell down.
Hey, come on, baby.
Gene, wait! How about, don't be a lamb, and you come back here, you lay that track down with us, together, right now. Oh, yeah.
He speaks for all of us.
Let's do it.
Babies, by the time you're all done here, you're going to be wearing gold-plated diapers.
What does that even mean, man?
Never question Bruce Dickinson. Roll it.
One, two, three, four!
Degrees last summer, and now this summer it's like negative 1,000. Like, I can't even.
Ugh, don't even.
Like, I'm trying to camp, but I can't.
You know, I wish I was wearing more layers because it's just so freaking cold in here.
I know. I'm literally wearing like 6 coats right now, and I'm trying to can, but I literally can't.
Is that window open? That window is literally wide open!
Okay, that is why it's frickin' Antarctica in here, because frickin' Margo has the window completely frickin' open!
Oh my god! Margo, can you please shut that window?
I can't!
Margo, I'm literally going to freeze to death if you don't shut that window.
I literally cannot. Both of my arms are broken. You know this. That's why you call me Broken Arms Margo, Stank Breath Margo, 2 broken arms.
Margo, you literally broke both of your arms like a year ago. And that's literally been your excuse for like everything now.
It's been 3 days. And I didn't do it on purpose. I stage dived at karaoke and nobody caught me.
Margo, you are so freaking dramatic. I am not doing this with you today.
Look, I know I'm not your favorite person in the world right now, but could you maybe just nudge my lunch a little bit closer? I've been trying to reach it for over an hour.
Marga! We are not walking 100 miles over to your desk when you can't even close the window. That's literally killing us!
Have you ever thought of anyone other than yourself?
Right? Like, oh my god.
There is no god. There can't be.
Marta, what is that on your shoulder?
Oh my god, it's so annoying. Just go like this.
Yeah, just go like this.
Oh my god, kill it, mother effer!
It's probably just snow from that open window.
Yeah, Marta, just like, go like this.
Yeah, just go like this.
You know that I can't. Both of my arms are broken from pits to wrist. Please, kill it or kill me.
Margo, you know what? It's fine. Just leave it there. But can you please close that window? It's literally freezing in here.
You know, if I had sleeves, my hands would be in them right now.
All right. You want me to close the window? I'll try. Oh! I'm alive, and I feel everything.
You know, she's literally never going to shut up about this.
I know. She's literally so dramatic.
not even!
Tango for a better tomorrow. Night.
Accusing me of breaking your glass.
Fake.
argument.
What was it?
It wasn't.
I don't think it was. That tiny straw is making me hate you.
That does it.
It does.
Anyways.
It does.
Okay, so. Boy, right. So, here's a question for you, crowd. Do you have the time?
Isn't a joke. We have to take a roast out of the freezer.
Yeah, no, we really have somewhere to eat. It's not a joke. If anybody could just let us know the time passed to buy us and stop looking at our phone.
It's 8:20!
What?
Oh, boy.
What are we going to do right now for dinner? Oh, my God.
I don't know. Just make noodles or something.
Yes, noodles would be your solution. That's what I like, because you would want
well, you've never cooked dinner, so I have to.
Listen, Nancy. Thank God. Right, well, anyways. Thank you all for having us tonight. Personally, I've had a terrible time.
Or has she?
That wasn't a joke. No piano noise. Oh, speaking of things that were jokes, however, I know what you were talking about earlier. It was a rooster, not a chicken.
Who eats roosters anyway?
Good question. Nobody knows. Anyways, moving on. So.
We wrote this joke together.
Yes, we did. I'm proud of it. Anyways, so. Oh, God, I'm stealing myself. It's a big one. Right. Just thinking about it. A rooster. It's on his way home from work. His little rooster car. He's got this nice briefcase, you know, nice gold briefcase. Lots of money. And he gets home to his little rooster, goes inside. Nobody's been in his house, you know, it's been a nice day. And he sits down after a long, hard day at work, his briefcase. And he opens his little rooster. Nancy, it's not that funny. He opens his little rooster briefcase. I'm sorry, I'm usually a professional about it. He opens his little rooster briefcase to find there's nothing in there.
There's nothing there.
Nancy, that's not the punchline. You wrote this joke, you know that. So, he opens his little rooster briefcase to find there's nothing there. And he says to himself, I can't believe I did this. Not yet. I cock-a-doodle can't believe I did this.
Favorite joke of all time.
That was a joke. Right. Well, look at that. One, two. One, two, three, four. Boodity-ta, obedity-da, flippity-dabba-dee-ba-dabba, that's our friend. See what we did there? That wasn't a joke. That was a clip.
It's the end.
And look at that. Oh my God, look at that. Fake drink, fake straw. Oh, fake Kit Kat wrapper. Fake Kit Kat bar. Fake skit, fake ending.
Fake show, fake happiness. We're incredibly angry.
And there we go. So, in common with this anger, we have my wonderful director, Molly. What's behind door number one? Oh, look at that, it's the cast. All right. And there we go. Is that moist sponge? Ladies and gentlemen, I believe that's a moist sponge.
This is a moist sponge!
I'd like to invite the freshman up to the front of the house. Come on, freshman, come to the back. Freshman, let's go. Come on, more than Nancy. Let's go. Come on. All right, it's time, Nancy. It's time to. Okay, now we're going to invite the freshman up. Tobias, would you like to lead the freshman? Sorry, not the freshman again. There's no double freshman. It's a sophomore. Tobias, let's go. Sophomore.
Thank you.
where you had Matt in the tech room who saved me, but also had a glass of chip on me. And then also, on top of that, we also have a stage crew behind us. We have a lot. We have that cat selling us. We have Dave Tech in the back. We have a janitor. We have everybody who thinks they're doing this. And then, we have people who have sound for fundraising. And that's our band. This is not a joke. This is not a joke. Flowers, thank you very much. Have a good night.